mining a little bit to make it bigger.
It looks
a little bit funny now. Mm-hmm. To make even the entrance bigger, but now somebody got the idea to make it smaller again, which is more nice. Because originally the entrance was just over this triangle, no?
Mm-hmm.
And then even they mined this away, no?
And the cave, directly at the top, the small cave.
Behind.
Is this the cave where the Siddha is living?
No, the guy,
do you know the story of the Siddha?
The guy who was on the top, no, for 12 years or something.
Aha, yeah.
Well, you mean this mythological
Arunagiri?
Yes, this
one.
Arunagiri Siddha, he's supposed to live on the northern slope
mm-hmm.
under a big banyan tree.
Aha.
Not in a cave, no?
Mm-hmm.
And some people claim they have found this tree.
Uh-huh.
There's one sadhu who brings people. That's on the side of Adi Annamalai.
Mm-hmm.
And, yeah.
So there's no path to this tree?
No.
Okay.
No, also not really known. No?
Mm-hmm.
Just in the scripture, they know there's this passage, no? That Shiva declares, I will be always present as a yogi under the north, on the northern slopes of Arunachala, no?
Mm.
Sitting under the big tree. And then in some scriptures they describe the tree and the situation, and they say, this tree is most amazing, it makes such a big shadow, no?
Mm-hmm.
Also somehow much bigger than the tree would
so
do,
yeah?
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm.
So even the gods are amazed
mm-hmm.
about this tree, they cannot understand what this is.
mm-hmm.
And under it is sitting Arunagiri.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Even Ramana describes this. He didn't find the tree, but one day while he was roaming around on the mountain, on the northern side,
mm-hmm.
this area where the tree is supposed to be, he suddenly found in a little mountain stream, there was a giant leaf of this kind of tree. No? And it reminded him instantly, oh, it must come from this big banyan tree under
mm-hmm.
the Arunagiri is sitting there.
Mm-hmm.
Because he never seen such a big banyan leaf. No? So he wanted to follow this stream to see where the leaf comes from. But while doing so, already after a short time, few minutes, he hit one bush and there was a nest of wasps.
Uh-huh.
And they started attacking his leg.
Mm-hmm.
And he said, interestingly, only the leg who hits him, the other leg, the rest of the body. Uh-huh. So he took it as a sign not to investigate
uh-huh.
further and
okay.
he went back down. No?
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
But somehow he must have told the story. So naturally, some of his devotees, they got very curious. So they started an expedition to find the tree also.
Course.
And it ended up in a big mess. They got completely lost in the torn bushes. Also. They hardly survived the night.
Mm-hmm.
So after that, nobody tried again.
And the guru from the top, he left to Kanyapuri, I think.
Yeah, Kanyakumari.
Kanyakumari.
And then now he's dead already. He died like 4 years ago or something.
4 years ago?
No, 2 years or was
it
2 years?
2 years, because 2 years ago,
I
think he was still alive 2 years ago.
Okay, I guess the timeline sometimes a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
But for sure he's dead.
Wenn man den sieht, dann kann
man nichts verstehen. Doch, I'm going to sitting on the top.
Oder
12 years or so.
Can you come out in the very south, right?
Yeah, yeah. And then at some point they brought him down because he had too much problem with the neck because you're always sitting in this squatting position like this. No? Then you don't need a problem with the blood circulation. They brought him down in the hospital. And after he recovered, they decided it's too hard to live on the top. They may make an ashram for him where he lives. No? It was his home village.
Hey, what was that joke you were going to tell us earlier?
Oh, there are so many. Which one?
whichever the last one you were trying to tell.
Ah, with the Sufi and the piss pot.
Sufi and a piss pot?
Mm.
What is
so
that?
This Russian couple, friends of mine, who were living in Caucasus, who had befriended the Sufi, no?
Uh-huh.
And he came from time to time. And then one visit, the wife, and she was very simple, very heartful, simple, natural girl. She wanted to cook some nice soup, but now there were three people. So she was looking for the biggest pot. And the biggest pot she found was this piss pot, the pet pot you have under the bed, no? And she cooked the soup, and it was a very tasty soup. And then when she brought it to the table, no? Her husband was like completely shocked. But the Sufi was laughing like crazy and said, you are a master.
Wow.
if you rehearse, well, it doesn't matter. When you want to make a big soup, you need a big pot.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
That was a big pot.
What was that about the Hungarian master?
Ah yeah, the guy who can predict the future, no?
Yeah, yeah.
That's a very long story. Tell maybe in the next game.
Or
no?
No,
no. Have you heard it? No, no?
No, not in a video.
Yeah.
Yeah, tell me, I'm listening.
Ah, it could even be something for our friends, because it's a very spiritual story.
What do you mean?
Yeah, they will enjoy it.
No. Yeah, you're welcome to listen. I will tell now a very old spiritual story.
Yeah.
It comes from Hungary, Ungarn. Mm-hmm. One woman from Ungarn told it me many years back. He said it's an old traditional Hungarian shamanistic story.
Uh-huh.
Really happened, no? From the old times.
Before, in
Hungary, no?
In Hungary.
Yeah, mm-hmm. It played in Hungary. It's before the Christianization, no? During the pagan times. No?
Mm-hmm.
But during that time, there was a shaman, a master, who had the power to predict the future. And one other man, he heard about the shaman.
This was?
To predict the future. Er konnte die Zukunft vorhersagen. No?
Mm-hmm.
So one man, he hears about this master, and he feels like, oh, if I could predict the future, how amazing my life would be, no? What big deeds I could perform. So he decides to visit the master and ask him if he can become his disciple and learn this art. So now he's lying in front of the master on the floor. He is asked and is waiting for the answer. And the master says after 50 minutes, I can teach you, but it will take some time. Because the future is a very vast topic. So you have to stay some time here. And the man says, no problem, I'm really dedicated, I really want to learn it. So now he's living there with the master, and after the time is passing by, and after 3 months, the man thinks by himself, I don't make any progress. Mm-hmm. Nothing happens, I'm already 3 months here. Because he's just busy with cooking the food, cleaning the house, getting the water, chopping the firewood. No? So he goes to the master and says, Master, I'm already 3 months here, but I feel like I make absolutely no progress. And the master looks at him and says, tomorrow I will teach you.
So
the next morning comes, and the man is already a little bit excited. No? And the master comes to him and says, we will go to the forest. So they start walking to the forest, and half the way, suddenly the master stops and says, in the forest, we will see many trees. So they come to the forest, and wow, it's full of trees, one tree next to the other. No? And the guy is like, oh my God, he predicted it. Now something is happening, I can feel it. No? So they walk through the forest, and suddenly the master stops and says, we will come to a place with many mushrooms. So they walk, and suddenly there's this empty space, and it's covered in mushrooms, no? And the guy says, wow, second time that he predicted it. Now something is happening, I can feel it. Oh, how lucky am I, no? So they go into the middle of this field, and when they reach the middle, the master stops and say, eat some of the mushrooms. So the man starts eating mushrooms, and already after a short time he starts to trip, no? And he says, oh my God, these are magic mushrooms. This is a profound shamanistic initiation. How lucky am I? And when he is full-scale tripping, no? Tripping out of his mind, the master grabs him and leads him carefully to a tree and tells him, embrace the tree. And the man is embracing the tree, and immediately he feels the energy, no? Like the tree is connecting earth and heaven. Amazing stuff is happening, and he's just like, wow, this is amazing, no? So he's standing there, and the master comes, and he has a big rope, and he says to the man, I will now tie you to the tree. So he ties the hands of the man behind the tree, no? And the man feels, oh my God, it's like I'm married to the tree, I'm getting tied to the tree. It's like a spiritual marriage of our animus. No? It's amazing, no? And then the master says, here's another rope. Now I will tie your feet to the tree. So he ties the feet of the man also very good to the tree. And then when the man is very well tied to the tree, the master comes and pulls down the trousers of the man. And the man, tied to the tree, he looks over his shoulders. And he sees how the master is pulling down his trousers also. And he looks and he shouts over his shoulder, Master, you're gonna fuck me! And the master comes to him and says, ah, there you can see how much progress you already have made. That we can learn, sometimes it's better not to ask for the future. Mm.
And where do you come from?
Hungary.
From Hungary. Jetzt könnte man glauben, dass es in Ungarn gegen die Praxis ist.
But I never heard this joke in Hungary. The first time I hear it from him.
I think he invented.
Most likely.
Very interesting Hungarian lady. She was studying Indian dance, no? Mm-hmm. And no, she said it's an old Hungarian story. Mm. Maybe she was pulling my lectures.
Maybe.
And what place in Hungary? Come from?
Budapest.
Budapest. Mm.
Mm. You want some peanuts, maybe? Peanuts, sweet peanuts. Very nice.
No, thank you.
Thank you.